On the line with us is Gina Csanyi, who is the Executive Director of the Toronto Roma Community Centre. Gina, good morning to you.
Good morning, Matt.
Let's start with you, Gina. What do you make of the proposed bill tabled by Jason Kenney yesterday?
As a whole, our entire community is quite devastated. It's very apparent that we're being targeted in this bill. And it, in fact, does nothing at all to address the growing escalation of violence against Roma in Europe, which is what propels the Roma people to come here. So it's, in fact, it's not dealing with the root cause of the problem yet again, which we continue to ask our government to help us in addressing, as a number of other countries are addressing. The U.S. is doing more to address the problem of violence against Roma in Europe than what we're doing. Meanwhile, we're the ones with all of the Roma refugees coming here, and we probably have the most legitimate reason to apply some pressure to these countries that, in fact, don't enforce their human rights agreements that they have agreed to. So though these instruments do exist in the country,
right,
there's very little implementation, accountability, or compliance with these human rights agreements.
Gina, the Roma community thought to be one of the groups, and you pointed this out, that the minister has in mind. He talked about democratic countries, particularly in Europe. Why would Roma people need to seek refugee status from a European Union country? Very briefly, just explain that.
Well, there's very little respect for the human rights of Roma across Europe, but particularly in Hungary and Czech Republic and Slovakia, there's a growing nationalist extreme right movement that continues to target the Roma with hate speech, hate violence, growing paramilitary groups. There's actually paramilitary armies operating in the country that the Hungarian government should be responsible for disbanding, enforcing the disbandment. They not only are operating, but they've set up two training camps. It's been an ongoing issue. There's forced labor camps in Hungary now. There's an ongoing problem with endemic discrimination amounting to persecution that continues to cripple this community. The vast majority of Roma refugees that are coming here, although there's a group of some of the most educated Roma coming from Hungary right now, then there's many high-profile ones that I can't speak about right now due to protecting their own privacy. So there's also a large community of illiterate people that are coming that have no idea about this very complex refugee system that we have here in Canada.
Now, Jason Kenney says that the number of refugee claims from Hungary has doubled in 2011 to 4,900, but that 95% of those claims are actually withdrawn and cost the taxpayers of Canada a lot of money. Why are so many of them withdrawn? That would lead some people, including the minister, to suggest that some of them are fraudulent claims.
I understand absolutely why that'd be alarming, but let me just say, Matt, that 95% is not accurate at all. There is currently, it's not a high acceptance rate, but there is an 18% acceptance rate of Roma refugee claims in 2011, and there was a 24% acceptance rate in 2010. Of those that have been either withdrawn or abandoned, that rate is closer to 65%. The reasons for this abandonment and withdrawal of claims often is due to people not having any knowledge of what a proper refugee claim is. When they come here, they're in fear, they're not prepared, they have very little access to medical documents and the legal documents, as well as police reports that they would need to make a successful refugee claim here, because they have very little access to any of this when they're there. So there's that problem of not being able to navigate this complex system,
right,
not knowing what they're prepared for and what they're up against. And there's another huge problem that we're dealing with right now in terms of very negligent legal representation. I cannot tell you how many cases that we have that we're submitting to Legal Aid Ontario regarding immigration consultants and lawyers that are doing absolutely no justice to these refugee claims.
Gina Csanyi, who's the Executive Director of the Toronto Roma Community Centre.